So today I'll be discussing about different types of MOS amplifier. In fact, for the last two or three classes, I have talked about a common source type of MOS amplifier, in which case the source terminal was considered to be common. In fact, we have applied the signal at the gate terminal and collected the output at the drain terminal. So collector, so drain to source was the output terminal, and the gate to source was the input terminal. So just like your common emitter configuration in BJT. So that part we have discussed in the last few classes. And we have also noticed one thing, that the gain of such an amplifier is primarily identified by GM times RD, where RD is the drain resistance. So the gain, if I just write down the expression for the gain for a common source type of amplifier, it was like, if I just consider the magnitude, so the magnitude of the gain was given by GM times RT. So if I want to increase the gain of such an amplifier, the option that is available to us is to increase the drain resistance RD. Now, sometimes it is required that this high value of drain resistance is to be connected to some lower value of the resistance. So as a matter of fact, if I connect it directly, then obviously some types of loss will take place. So for this particular purpose, we need a buffer. So we have already, perhaps you know the concept of the buffer from your knowledge in electronic circuits. So here also the same types of, the notion of buffer will be there. So in this particular case, if I want to connect some higher value of resistance to a lower value of resistance, then we need a kind of buffer, a voltage buffer, and the common drain type of amplifier, MOS amplifier, will serve the purpose. Just like a common collector type of amplifier, if you can recall the discussion which we made in electronic circuits, perhaps you can remember that the common collector type of amplifier is having a unity gain. In fact, if I just consider the exact value of the gain, it was less than one. But for the sake of simplicity, we may assume that the gain value is almost close to one, but it can never cross one. So it's not an amplifier, but it acts like a buffer, the common collector amplifier. So what was the different attributes pertaining to a common collector amplifier? If you can recall, for a common collector amplifier, the input impedance is pretty large and the output impedance is very small. So a common collector amplifier can convert a very high value, or can connect a very high value of input resistance to a very lower value of load resistance. So that purpose was solved by a common collector type of amplifier, BJT amplifier. A similar type of notion is also applicable for a MOS amplifier, in which case this is done by a common drain type of amplifier, common drain type of MOS amplifier. So first of all, very briefly, let me draw the circuit diagram for a common drain type of MOS amplifier. So as you understand, for a common drain type of amplifier, once again, the input signal is applied at the gate terminal. So let me draw the MOS structure first. So these are the three terminals, gate, drain, and the source. And the input signal is applied over here, Vin. And since it's a common drain, so the drain terminal is directly connected to the supply, power supply, that is VDD. And we have the load resistance here. This load resistance, right now I'm considering the load resistance a discrete resistance, that is simple RS kind of this, or later on we can replace this source resistance, this particular resistance, this load resistance, by means of an equivalent MOS architecture. So this is the resistance RS. Now we're applying input at the gate terminal, and we are collecting the output at the source terminal. So this one is V out. So this particular architecture is for common. Let me first write down the name. That is common drain MOS amplifier. Last day we have discussed about the common source. Now this is common drain amplifier, a common drain MOS amplifier. And we will observe that here the input is being applied at the gate terminal, and the output will follow the input. There is a change of VGS, gate to source voltage. If I just consider the shifting over here, the Vout minus Vin, that difference is nothing but the VGS gate to source voltage. So once again, the output voltage will follow the input voltage. So just like the same concept, you can also apply over here, just like a common collector kind of amplifier where input was applied at the base and the output was collected from the emitter terminal and the collector was connected directly to the VCC or power supply line. And that configuration was known as common collector, or in other words, it is also known as emitter follower. So here also this common drain amplifier is known as the source follower kind. So common drain or source follower circuit, or source follower amplifier, because the source will follow the input signal which is applied over here. A common drain or source follower amplifier. So the meaning is the same. Now let us try to identify what happens whenever we apply some input signal over here. What about the status of the MOS amplifier and what about the output voltage that will be developed over here? So one thing is very clear that whenever the input signal is very small, like if I start from a very small value, like from 0 volt, then what happens is MOS amplifier, this NMOS amplifier is not on. So the corresponding voltage is gate to source voltage initially. When the input signal is very small, there is no current flowing through the circuit. So I'm just neglecting the sub-threshold conduction, that if the input signal is less than the threshold voltage, almost there is no current and that is flowing through the circuit. And you can expect that the output voltage equal to zero, because the V output is nothing but this drop across this source resistance, that is RS. So when the input signal is very small, then the MOS is off and accordingly the output voltage is also zero. Now, when the input signal crosses this Vin, when it crosses the threshold voltage, that is VTH, then only this MOS will become on. Now, when the MOS is on, then the next question is that in which region the MOS is getting on, whether it is in the saturation region or it is in the triode region or linear region. So we have to identify that particular point first. So whether the MOS will be on in the saturation region or in the linear region or active region. So for this particular purpose, you have to identify the different terminal voltage. So as you understand, this gate to source voltage for this particular configuration is nothing but the gate voltage is Vin and the source voltage is Vout. So Vin minus Vout, this is the gate to source voltage. And what about the drain to source voltage? The drain to source voltage is given by the drain voltage is VDD and the source voltage is Vout. So VDD minus Vout. So you know the condition for the saturation region, because always we expect that the MOS becomes on in the saturation region whenever it is acting as an amplifier. And the condition is that the VDS value, VDS should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VTH. Now, if this condition gets satisfied, VGS minus VTH, then the MOS will be in the saturation region. Now, if I just put this condition over here, we will find that VDD minus Vout, it should be greater than or equal to Vin minus Vout minus VTH. So if I further simplify this one, then VDD plus VTH. So if it is greater than or equal to Vin, if this is the condition that if Vin is less than or equal to VDD plus VTH, so then always this MOS will become on in the saturation region. Now, normally we apply the input signal which is less than the drain supply, because this is the highest voltage available in the circuit. So since normally Vin value is less than VDD, so we expect always that this, whenever the input signal is higher than the threshold voltage, so whenever Vin is greater than VTH, so whenever Vin is greater than VTH, this M1 becomes, or this particular MOS, if I consider it to be say M1, so this M1 is on, and it is on in saturation region, because this condition gets satisfied, saturation region. So first of all, we have identified one point that when the input signal is just greater than the threshold voltage, this MOS will become on and it will be on in the saturation region. Now, if it is on in the saturation region, so we have to identify what is the current that is flowing. So we know the expression for the drain current. So the expression for the drain current ID is nothing but we can remember that equation, that is half mu n C ox W by L into VGS minus VTH whole square. So right now I'm just neglecting the effect of the channel length modulation. So right now, and moreover, I'm just also neglecting the body effect over here. because as you understand that the source is not connected to the ground, so obviously there will be certain body effect. But right now I'm just neglecting those second order effects. So first of all, let us complete the discussion with the primary effect, and then we'll be gradually introducing those second order effects. So the drain current or ID is given by half mu n Cox W by L into VGS minus VTH whole square. So what is VGS? This is nothing but Vin minus Vout. Vin minus Vout, this is VGS minus VTH whole square. And that is the expression for the drain current, and accordingly we can write down the expression for the output voltage. So the output voltage is given by this ID times RS, ID times RS. So that is given by half mu n Cox W by L V in minus V out minus VTH whole square into RS. This is the expression for the output voltage. Now from this expression, we have to find out the expression for the gain. That is nothing but the variation of the output voltage with respect to the variation of the input voltage. Now let me just once again copy that expression which I've already written over there. That is V out is equal to half mu n Cox W by L V in minus V out minus VTH whole square into RS. So that is the expression for the output voltage, V out. So now if I differentiate with respect to V in, partial differentiation, then it will give us del V out by del V in. That is equal to, so half and two, so it gets cancelled. So I can write like mu n Cox W by L, then say V in minus V out minus VTH. That is fine. And then we have to differentiate the internal part. What is there inside? So one minus, it will be like del V out by del V in. That is fine, as you understand. And then the next part, so VTH is not constant. So remember, now we are gradually introducing the second order effects one after another. And so if you just once again look at the circuit, so here the source potential is nothing but the output potential, and it will vary with respect to the input voltage. So it is not constant. So when the input is large, the output is large, and the input is small, the output is small. So the source potential will follow the gate potential. So that's why it is known as source follower circuit. And what about the body potential or substrate potential? If I consider it is grounded, so obviously the VSB value, that means the source to bulk potential, source to body potential. So the source to body potential is not equal to zero always, because source is not grounded. If both source and body, they are grounded, then obviously VSB equal to zero always. But here the body potential, even if it is grounded, but the source potential is not grounded. It is it follows the input potential to some extent. So therefore, the VSB is not constant. So therefore, so body effect has to be considered in this particular case, and accordingly the threshold voltage will vary with respect to the input voltage. So threshold voltage is not constant. So therefore, the threshold voltage as a function of the input voltage, so it will be like del VTH by del Vin, and then we have this RS. So how to calculate this del VTH by del Vin? So we know that VTH by del Vin, so I can write this expression as del VTH by del V out into del V out by del Vin as a chain rule. Now what is V out over here? So V out is nothing but the source to bulk potential, VSB. This is nothing but VSB, V out. So V out here, so V out is nothing but VSB, the source to bulk potential. So already in some of the lectures we have already calculated the expression for this del VTH by del VSB. Del VTH by del VSB. So it was like that value we can simplify to be eta. So ultimately this del VTH by del Vin is nothing but eta times del V out by del Vin. And one thing you must remember that this eta is not also a constant quantity. It depends upon the VSV value. It is like gamma by 2 root divided by gamma by 2 into 1 upon root over of twice pi a plus PSP. So that particular thing, this eta, you can remember that was the expression we have already proved. It was like for NMOS twice pi f plus VSP. So it is not also constant. So it also, it's a weaker function of the output voltage because VSP is nothing but the V out. So I'm coming to that point later. So first of all, let me just find out the expression for the gain. So coming back to this expression once again, what we are getting, this del V out by del V, so I can write it like AV, the expression for the gain. So that is equal to mu n C aux W by L into V in minus V out minus VTH. And then we have the additional part, that is 1 minus this del V out by del V in is nothing but AV. And this one is eta times AV minus eta times AV. And then we have RS. Now remember this one, this expression mu n C aux W by L into VGS minus VTA. So this is nothing but the transconductance of the MOS amplifier. Mu n C aux W by L, V in minus V out minus VTH. So this is nothing but the transconductance. So I can write this to be GM times 1 minus AV minus eta times AV into RS. So ultimately, it can be simplified to GM times RS into 1 minus 1 plus eta times AV. So if I take it in one side, so AV into 1 plus GM RS into 1 plus eta is equal to GM RS. And from that, we can let me go to the next slide and let me write down the final expression for the gain, that is AV. So ultimately, this AV is given by in the numerator, we have GM times RS. And in the denominator, we have 1 plus GM RS into 1 plus eta. GM RS into 1 plus eta. So that can also be simplified like it was GM RS in the numerator. And in the denominator, we have 1 plus. So if you can remember, eta times GM was nothing but GMB. So that is nothing but GM plus GMB into RS. So that is the final expression for the gain. And you can very easily verify that this expression of the gain, it is having two different components. First of all, it is positive. That means the gain is not negative. So there is no phase difference between the input and output because there is no negative sign outside. So it is positive. That is the first attribute of the gain. And the second attribute of the gain is that the gain is always less than 1. In the numerator, you have GM times RS. And in the denominator, you have GM times RS plus something. So obviously the numerator is less than the denominator. So obviously the value of AV, this value of AV is always less than 1. So that is the thing. It's always less than 1. Now, whenever the input signal is very small, so if I consider that the input value, I mean, it is just higher than the threshold voltage, VTH. So under this condition, the mutual conductance, that is GM value is also very small. And this entire thing, if I just consider, this is GMRS into 1 plus eta, since it is small. So I can consider this entire thing, the AV, the expression for AV is also very small. Now, whenever the value of the input voltage is large as compared to the threshold voltage, for a very high value of the input voltage, when the Vin is much greater than the threshold voltage, then the current carrying capacity of the MOS is also large, because as you know, ID is proportional to the Vin minus Vout minus VTH whole square. So as the Vin minus VTH, so that as the difference is increases, is accordingly we can find that the corresponding value of AV, or rather the gain, will also increase. So when the GMRS value, or rather the GM value, is much large, so for pretty high value of the input voltage, for large Vin, what we can write is the expression for AV can be approximated, because this part can be considered to be larger with respect to one. Initially, when the input is small, and then that part that part is not very large with respect to one. But when the input signal is much larger, then since the value of GM is also large, so therefore this product GM RS into 1 plus eta, it is also large with respect to one. So I can just neglect this one for very large value of Vin, and then the expression of AV becomes like GM times RS in the numerator, and in the denominator you have like GM times RS into 1 plus eta, which is equal to like GM by GM plus GMB, or equivalently I can write this expression to be 1 by 1 plus eta, same thing. And the value of eta also reduces with the increasing value of the input voltage. Why? I'm just once again try to explain that part. Let me very briefly draw the circuit once again over here. This is the circuit. So we have a VDD supply over here. The input signal is applied at this point. Now this is the source resistance, and the output is obtained over here. This is the Vout, and this one is Vin. The expression for eta was like gamma by 2 twice pi a plus VSV. Now what is this VSV? VSV is nothing but the source to bulk potential. So this is nothing but, so what you can see over here, eta is proportional to 1 upon root over of Vout, because VSV is equal to Vout. So it is proportional to that. So roughly you can say that as VSV or Vout increases, the eta value drops down. And as eta drops down, so for practical circuit, the eta can be as small as 0.1 to 0.2. So under this case, you can find out what is the expression for the AV. So if the eta is equal to exactly 0, and then obviously you can say that the AV will be 1. That is the maximum possible value, theoretically. But the eta cannot reach to 0. The minimum possible value for eta is like 0.1 to 0.2. So therefore, accordingly, you can calculate the highest possible value of AV, like 1 upon 1.2, like this. So if I just draw the variation of the input versus output, so it was something like that. So this is the transfer characteristics, as you know, the variation of the input versus output. So there is a maximum limit. So this is 1. And the variation is something like that. So initially, when the input is less than the threshold, the output is 0. And then it is something like that. So that is the variation, and we can expect that the highest possible value for Vout, or rather what I have done is Vout, so it will be better if I write like Vout upon Vin. So that will be perfect. It's not Vout, rather. It is expression for the gain. That is expression for the gain, so AV versus Vin. So when the input voltage is less than the threshold, so the gain is 0, because the output voltage is 0 before VTH, before the threshold voltage. And as the threshold voltage is crossed, as input voltage is the higher than the threshold voltage, then the corresponding gain expression will increase, and accordingly the highest possible value for AV, theoretically it could have been 1, but practically it is limited to close to 0.8 to 0.9. So it shows the variation of the input, the variation of the gain with respect to the input voltage. So here the maximum value is equal to, the maximum value for the gain is equal to 1. So if I want to draw the transfer characteristics, so Vin versus Vout, then this highest possible value will be Vin only. I think there has been certain problem with the presentation, so let me just come back. Yes, we have caught something. Let's wait for a minute. Hopefully you can view the screen right now. So let me just once again very briefly write down what we have missed. So for the large value of gain, it was like GMRS upon 1 plus GM plus GMB into 1. And that value can be neglected. So it was like GMRS divided by GM plus GMB into RS. So that is equal to 1 by 1 plus eta. And we have already shown the variation of the gain with respect to the input voltage. And let me very briefly draw it once again. So Vin versus what you can do is either you can write the variation of, or you can draw the variation of Vin versus Vout. So under which case you have to mark the maximum possible value to be equal to Vin. So that is the pattern. So this value equal to VTH, the threshold voltage. So the expression what you have got for this source follower circuit is like 1 by 1 upon eta. For very large value of Vin, and the eta value is like close to 0.1 to 0.2, so the value of AV can be close to like 0.8 to 0.9. So we can also arrive at the same expression from the small signal equivalent circuit. So so far we have considered the mathematical model. Now let me very briefly go to the small signal model of the same circuit. So for this purpose, let me once again draw the circuit, and it will help you to identify the small signal model. So this one is PDD. This one is Vin, input voltage, and the output is obtained from this point. This resistance RS. So if I just consider the small signal model over here, what will you find is we can draw the small signal model like plant the Vin within the gate to the ground. That is Vin, the input voltage. And this drop is equal to V1. And we have GM V1, the voltage dependent current source. We have GM V1 between the drain and the source. And we do have another voltage dependent current source to take into account the effect of the body effect. So this is nothing but GMV times VBS. And ultimately, stimulate. So this is the source terminal. And the drain is grounded because it is connected to VDD. And here we do have the resistance RS. And this output is Vout. So from this expression also, we can find out the expression for the gain just by observing this small signal model. So what we can find is from the small signal model, the input voltage Vin can be written like V1 plus Vout. And Vout is nothing but, if I consider the current that is flowing through it is ID. The current that is flowing through the source resistance RS, if I consider that current to be equal to ID, then that current can be represented by this. Let it be like ID times RS. And this ID can be represented by GM times V1 plus GMB times VBS. Now we know that Vin is equal to V1 plus Vout. So from that I can write V1 is equal to Vin minus Vout. And what about VBS? VBS is nothing but VB minus VS. So this is nothing but minus Vout. VBS is nothing but the voltage drop between the voltage difference between the bulk and the source, substrate and the source. So then source potential is given by Vout. So therefore VBS is equal to minus Vout. And V1 is equal to Vin minus Vout from this expression. So ultimately what we have is, so I think it will be better. Okay, let me write down over here. GM times Vin minus Vout. Minus GMB times Vout. So that is expression for ID. So ultimately Vout, and that is equal to ID times RS. So GM Vin minus GM plus GMB Vout multiplied with RS. So from this expression, if I take it in one side, the expression for Vout, so we'll find that Vout multiplied with 1 plus GM plus GMB into RS, and that is equal to GM RS into Vin And it is very clear from this expression that V out upon V in, the expression for the gain is given by GM times RS divided by 1 plus GM plus GMVRS. So we have arrived at the same expression from two different approaches. One through the mathematical model, considering the expression for the drain current when the MOS is operating in the saturation region. And the second thing, we have arrived the same expression using the small signal model of the MOS amplifier. And sometimes this small signal model will be helpful whenever we do have to calculate for a complicated circuit. Now, this is all about the source follower circuit, or what is known as the common drain amplifier. But obviously, this particular circuit is having some serious disadvantages. Now, one disadvantage is coming in the form of the nonlinearity. So already you have seen that the value of the threshold voltage heavily depends upon the input voltage. So that's why we have to introduce the concept of eta, or rather GMV over here, because the source potential is not constant. The source potential varies with respect to the input potential. And as a matter of fact, because of the variation of the VSB, that is the source to bulk potential, because of the variation of this with respect to the input voltage, the threshold voltage varies, and hence it gives rise to a kind of nonlinearity. So we'll be coming into the nonlinearity part later on. And before that, let me just try to identify what are the advantages out of this source follower circuit. And first of all, you have to identify the impedance provided by this kind of amplifier. Now to find out this output impedance of this type of amplifier, so first of all, what you need to do is that we have to once again follow the small signal model, and accordingly we have to find out the expression for the output impedance. So you know that how to find out the output impedance. So this is the output terminal. So we do have an output terminal over here, and what we do, we just connect one externally applied voltage signal like Vx, and let us try to find out what is the value of the current being drawn by the circuit, considering that the input voltage is grounded or input voltage is absent. Now, under this condition, when the input voltage is absent, then what about the Vx by Ix ratio? That will give you the expression for the output resistance. Now, one thing I have to mention over here, that the source resistance that I'm talking about initially is RS, which will act as the load resistance in this particular case. Now, although we have started our discussion just by considering a discrete resistance like RS, but it is also possible to replace that particular resistance by means of an NMOS amplifier operating in saturation region. So now we will be trying to implement this source resistance or this entire thing, RS, by means of a current source. And the current source can also be implemented by means of MOS amplifier. So if I consider that, in fact, we have also considered to implement the drain resistance RD for a common source type of amplifier, which we have discussed in the last classes, that the drain resistance RD can be implemented by several means. One of the means was that you can implement by means of a diode connected load. Similarly, you can also represent RD by means of a current source. If I represent the RD, the drain resistance that time, by means of a current source, you would have certain advantages. The advantage was that for a drain resistance, if I explicitly use a drain resistance RD for a common source type of amplifier, then you have seen that the voltage drop across RD and the swing, the output voltage swing, they are very strongly related. Now, on the other hand, instead of using a simple discrete resistance, if I replace the resistance by means of a current source, the additional advantage what we are getting over here is that the drop across the resistance and the output voltage, so these two parameters, they are loosely coupled. So that part was discussed in some previous classes whenever we have considered the effect of using a current source model of load. So similarly, we can also replace the load resistance over here. So last time when we have considered a common source kind of amplifier, so that time RT, the drain resistance, was the output resistance, rather the load resistance which was connected between the drain terminal and the VDD line, the supply and the drain. And this time the source terminal is the output terminal, so therefore the source to ground, so that is the, that is serving the purpose of the output resistance. So similarly, we can implement this one by means of a current source. And you know that ideally, for an ideal current source, the resistance offered by the current source is infinite, an ideal current source. So this is the V in value and this one is the V out. So that is the equivalent model. And this current source, so although I am showing it by the current source, so we can always implement for a integrated circuit. So this current source is not like a current source, rather it should be implemented by means of a MOS amplifier. So the MOS amplifier itself will act as a current source. So that is equivalent to, so this is a symbolic model by means of a current source. And let me show you the MOS based architecture. It was like so we are representing that current source by means of another MOS amplifier, and obviously it will be acting in the saturation region, because you know for saturation region the current is constant, and suppose the corresponding potential, gate potential, is constant, like some VB, and we have applied the input voltage over here, that is Vin, and we are taking the output from this terminal, that is the Vout terminal. So by means of this arrangement, we can get rid of the nonlinearity to some extent, but the effect of the, or the impact on the body order, body effect, what we have considered already, the second order effect, the body effect, so that cannot be eliminated by virtue of this. So with this, let me just very briefly show you the process of calculating the output resistance. So you know how to calculate the output resistance. So this is the output terminal. Now you have to look from this terminal like this. So you need to look from this terminal what is the value of R out, because this is the output terminal. So how to do that? So you have to connect one external voltage at this particular point, like Vx, and you have to find out what is the current being drawn by the circuit, considering that the input voltage or input signal is grounded. So that can be done. So equivalently, so let me just show you the corresponding small signal model. So the input voltage is absent. So this is grounded. So between these two, we have like V1. And this one is GM times V1. So far we have not considered the effect of the channel length modulation, but gradually we'll be incorporating the effect of channel length modulation as well. And this one is GMB times VBS. And this is the drain terminal, so it is connected to the ground, AC ground. And we have to connect some external voltage over here. Let this voltage be represented by Vx, and suppose the current being drawn by the circuit is given by Ix. So obviously you understand what is the output resistance R out looking from this terminal. So R out is given by Vx upon Ix. That is out, because this is the output terminal. This one is the output terminal. Source is the output terminal. So I have to connect the external voltage between the output terminal and the ground, between source and ground, Vx. And the current being drawn by the circuit is, suppose, Ix. So let me consider that. So this is Vx. So you understand that V1 is nothing but minus Vx from simple KVL. V1 is equal to minus Vx. And Ix, and what about VBS? So VBS is nothing but VB minus Vs. So that is minus Vs. And so that is like minus Vx. because source potential is equal to Vx. So ultimately, what we find is, if I apply the KVL at the source node, if I apply the KVL, so we find that GM times V1 plus GMB times VBS plus IX. So all of them are entering. So the direction is the same. So that is equal to zero. So it is nothing but GM times V1 is minus VX, and this is minus VX. So let me take this is in one side. So GM times, let me just correct it. So it was like GM times VX plus GMB times VX, that is equal to IX. So from that, we can very easily calculate VX upon IX. That is nothing but 1 upon GM plus GMB. 1 upon GM plus GMB. So that is the output resistance, R out. So R out is given by, for this source follower circuit, 1 upon GM plus GMB. So because of the body effect, because of the presence of GMB, the R out value, the output impedance is reduced to a certain extent. So that is one of the advantages whenever you are going to connect the source follower circuit to a load which is having a very small value. And so that is one of the advantages. So it will act as a buffer. The input resistance is very large, essentially so because the input is applied at the gate terminal and the gate is insulated. So therefore, whenever you have applied the input signal to the gate, so obviously the input impedance is pretty large, but the output impedance is very small for this type of amplifier because of the presence of this GMB terms over here. So 1 upon GM plus GMB. So output resistance is small and the input resistance is large, and it will act as a voltage buffer. There is no gain provided by this circuit. Now, another point which we have to identify at this particular moment is that if I just closely observe this current source. Now we have this current source whose magnitude is given by GMB times VBS. So the magnitude of the current source is given by GMB times VBS, and it is connected. So what about VBS? So VBS is nothing but minus VX. And it is connected between two terminal whose potential drop is also equal to VX. So equivalently, instead of writing GMB times VBS, I can also write this to be like GMB times, I think it will be better if I draw a new circuit. Let me go to the next slide and draw the new circuit. So it was like for this source follower circuit. If I just very quickly draw the circuit, so we have, so the input is not applied over here. So this one is V1. So this one is GM times V1. And we do have GMB times VBS. So this is VX, and the current drawn by the circuit is IX. So this potential is VX. Now we do have GMB times VBS. So what is VBS? So VBS is nothing but minus VS. That is equal to minus VX. Because this VS is nothing but VX. The source potential is nothing but VX. So instead of connecting GM V1, rather GMB times VBS, so instead of connecting, instead of showing the direction from this terminal to that terminal, I can also revert this with a potential equal to, I mean, with a value equal to GMB times VX. In fact, it was like from the drain to source, with a magnitude equal to GMV times VBS, and VBS is equal to minus VX. So the both of them will give us the same implication. GMV times VBS. That means GMV times VBS is minus VX. Minus VX. That means minus GMV times VX. So that is equivalent to GMV times VX. Same thing. So this is the drain terminal. This one is the source terminal. This is the drain terminal. This one is the source terminal. So equivalently, I can write like GMV times VX. Now, what is the current source is connected between these two terminals with magnitude equal to GMV times VX. And what about the potential drop between these two points? The potential drop is equal to VX. So current source is connected between two terminals, and the potential drop between these two terminals is equal to VX. That means the current source is having a value which is proportional to the voltage drop between the two terminals. So ultimately, it gives rise to the notion of a resistance. Now, if I have a current source like this between these two terminals, suppose A and the B, and if the magnitude of the current source, suppose I, now, if this current source I, let this be I. So if this I is proportional to the VAB, so obviously this current source can be equivalently represented by means of a simple resistance. So the same notion is also applied over here. So this small signal model can be further simplified to be like this. So we have GM times V1. This is grounded. And this is VX. The current drawn by the circuit is IX. This one is V1. And this GMV times VX, this voltage dependent current source is proportional to the value of VX. So therefore, this could have been equivalently represented by means of a resistance, and whose value is given by 1 upon GMV. So this type of representation will help you analyzing the circuit whenever the circuit is much more complicated. Now, remember that this type of representation is only possible for a source follower circuit. For a common source type amplifier, which we have discussed in the last day, so this is not possible. The voltage dependent current source GMV times VBS can be represented by means of a resistance value equal to 1 upon GMV is only possible because here the current source or the magnitude of the current source is proportional to a voltage, and this voltage is nothing but the potential difference between the two terminals between which the current source is connected. The current source is connected between A to B, between these two terminals, A to B, and the current is proportional to this VAB. So it gives the notion of a resistance. And the resistance value is given by 1 upon GMV. I can be represented by V by R. So R is given by 1 upon GMV. So under this condition, it will help us analyzing the circuit. So with this notion, we can also arrive at the same expression for the gain. So very briefly, Let me show you. Let me start with the common source follower circuit. With the current source load, and as you understand, for a current source load, the output impedance is ideally infinite, pretty large. So this one is VDD, and this point is Vout. Now we are applying input signal over here. Now let us try to calculate the expression for the gain. Already we have calculated the expression from two different approaches. Now let us try to calculate the expression of the gain from another approach. So what we do here, we have applied the input signal, that is Vin. Now we have GM times V1 that is connected between the drain and the source terminal. So this one is V1. And remember, here we do have this GMB times VBS can equivalently be represented by means of simple resistance, whose value is equal to 1 upon GMB. For a source follower circuit. And this potential, I mean, this point is nothing but the output potential. Now, if I want to find out the Thevenin equivalent resistance between this point and this point, between this point and this point, if I want to find out the Thevenin equivalent resistance, you find that the Thevenin equivalent resistance between these two points is nothing but 1 upon GM. Because in order to find out the Thevenin equivalent resistance, you have to make all the voltage source inactive. So how to make it inactive? You have to make it short circuited. And whatever the value over here, the current source, the value equal to GM times V1. And what is the difference between this point and this point? This is nothing but V1. So equivalently, this Thevenin equivalent model of the circuit can be represented by, so we do have V in over here. So this is the terminal, this is the gate terminal. Now as you find here, the voltage drop is V1 and the current source between these two points is nothing but GM times V1. So equivalently, this could have been represented by means of a resistance whose value is given by 1 upon GM. And we do have another resistance whose value is given by 1 upon GMB. That is true whenever the source resistance RS is pretty large. So we have considered here, remember in this particular case, we have considered that RS is much, much larger. RS is very, very large. It's very large. So that's why it has been represented by means of a current source. So because you know, for a current source, for an ideal current source, the output resistance, I mean, the resistance is equal to infinity. And if it is a practical current source, then also the resistance value is very, very large. And this one is Vout. So in fact, we can consider that, okay, there is some RS connected between the source and the ground, but that value is very large. So you can just neglect the current flowing through the resistance. So under this condition, you can very easily find out the expression for the gain. So what is Vout upon Vin? This expression is nothing but if I just apply the simple KVL over here. So this is nothing but 1 upon GMB. Divided by 1 upon GM plus 1 upon GMB, a voltage divider law. And that can be written by gm by gm plus gmv. So ultimately we have arrived at the same expression. In fact, we have seen that that expression was like the expression for the gain. The expression for the gain was like we have already seen that AV, it was like GM times RS divided by 1 plus GM plus GMB times RS. So that is the exact expression for the voltage gain for a source follower circuit. GMRS divided by 1 plus GM plus GMB times RS. Now here we have considered that RS is very, very large. So that can be equivalently represented by GM upon 1 by RS plus GM plus GMB. Now under the condition that RS is much, much large, so then 1 by RS can be neglected. So can be approximated to 0. And then the expression for AV reduces to GM upon GM plus GMB. So that can also be evaluated, or that can also be observed from another angle. So we have shown three different approaches to calculate the expression for the gain. The first approach was through the expression of the current. The MOS is operating in the saturation region, so we know the expression for the current, and the current multiplied with the resistance RS will give you the expression for the voltage V out. And accordingly, by taking this partial derivative of V out with respect to V in, we have calculated the expression for the gain, that is AV. That was the first approach. The second approach we have considered, okay, we do have some small signal model, small signal equivalent model, and let us go by that and find out the expression for the output versus input, V out upon V in. That was the second approach. And in the third approach, it was a slight modification of the second approach. We have little bit, we have modified the expression for, or rather we have modified the small signal model, small signal architecture of the MOS amplifier by replacing the current source by means of equivalent resistance, just by observing the point between which the current source are connected and what about the potential or what about the amplitude of the current source. So accordingly, we have replaced or we have substituted those current sources by means of equivalent resistances, and accordingly we have found out the expression for the voltage gain. In fact, that model will be helpful whenever we will be analyzing some complicated circuit. So for example, let me just consider once a circuit with a finite load resistance as well, a little bit complicated circuit. So let me consider that we have a circuit like this. And then very briefly, we will be finding out the expression for the current, or rather the overall expression for the gain, by using this simplified model. So this is the first amplifier, I mean the first MOS, that is M1 if I consider, and the input is applied over here. And we do have a source resistance, and the source resistance is being replaced or represented by means of another MOS amplifier. So that could have been represented by a second MOS amplifier. Remember, the second MOS amplifier M2 is acting as a current source. So that's why this potential, this gate potential, is constant, which is equal to VB. This is constant. And this will not amplify this will not take part in the amplification. The amplification is basically done by the MOS amplifier, MOS device M1. And suppose we do have some load resistance, external load resistance. Suppose the output of the MOS is to be delivered to some external load resistance, and whose value is equal to, say, RL. And this is the V out terminal. So for this circuit, if you have to find out the expression of the gain, V out by V in, then it will be easier for you if you go by the small signal equivalent model. This will help you in finding out the expression of the gain. And in this particular case, let us also try to incorporate the channel length modulation as well. So with this, let me just find out the expression for the gain by virtue of the small signal model. So the input signal V in is over here, and we have this drop like V1, and this one is Gm times V1. That one is Gm times V1. So this is the output terminal. Now, first of all, we have to identify the different elements which are connected between this terminal and the ground. So the first element which is connected between this terminal and the ground is nothing but 1 upon GMB. Already you have seen that. That can be represented over here. We have seen that this can be represented by means of a simple resistance whose value is equal to 1 upon GMB. So the same thing can be implemented over here. So we do have this resistance whose value is equal to 1 upon GMB. And this takes into account the impact of body effect for the transistor M1, for the MOS M1. Remember, for the second MOS or M2, there will be no body effect because its source is connected to the ground. So obviously, there will be no body effect for the second transistor, second MOS. What about the other resistances which are connected? Now, let us try to incorporate the other resistances in the form of the channel length modulation. So far, we have just neglected the channel length modulation. But you know that for the MOS operating in the submicron range, obviously, the channel length modulation is very much pertinent and prominent as well. So we cannot get rid of the channel length modulation. So we do have to connect the drain to source. Between the drain to source, we need to connect this R0 value, the RO value we have to connect. So here the drain is already grounded because this is drain is directly connected to the VDD, that is the constant potential, so DC supply. So this is equivalent AC ground. So therefore, I can also connect between source to ground. It will be having the same impact. So let me first draw for the upper transistor, that is M1. So it will be like RO1. So it should be connected between the drain and the source of MOS1. So for the MOS1, the source is this terminal, which is nothing but the output terminal, Vout, and the drain is grounded. So I can also connect it over here. That is RO1. Then there will be another resistance in the form of RO2 for this particular MOS. This is connected between the drain to source. Now, the drain for the second MOS is nothing but the source for the first MOS. So therefore, it is connected between the Vout terminal and the ground terminal, which is AC ground. And apart from that, we do have the load resistance RL connected over here. RL. Now, under this condition, if I would like to find out the expression for the gain, that is AV, which is nothing but Vout upon Vin. So already we have seen that in the last example. So how to find it out? So this is nothing but 1 upon GMB divided by 1 upon GM plus 1 upon GMB. So now here I cannot write like 1 upon GMB only. Rather, we do have the other resistance as well coming in shunt with the 1 upon GMB. So the expression was like 1 upon GMB divided by 1 upon GM plus 1 upon GMB. So instead of writing 1 upon GMB, so I have to write like 1 upon GMB. And we have parallel combination with RO1. Then we have this resistance like RO2. and then you have this resistance like RL. So this is the equivalent resistance connected between the source and the ground. And in the denominator, we should have 1 upon GM plus 1 upon GMV. So I can simply write like 1 upon GM and this entire thing. 1 upon GMV parallel RO1, parallel RO2, parallel RL. So if I just follow this small signal equivalent model for this type of amplifier circuit, this type of circuit which involves a lot of MOS devices, so it will help you in finding out the final expression for the gain with much more ease as compared to the first model which we have considered just by finding out the gain by writing down the expression of the current whenever the MOS is operating in the saturation region, and then just by taking the partial differentiation of V out with respect to V in. So with respect to that particular model, this model will help you in calculating the gain with much more ease. Now, so far we have discussed some of the aspects of this source follower circuit or a common drain amplifier circuit. But one of the biggest limitation of this source follower circuit comes in the form of the available voltage swing. So what do you mean by available voltage swing? So you know, to understand the effect of, or you know, to understand the notion of the voltage swing, so let me just show you a simple common drain amplifier first. Suppose I'm having some common drain amplifier. Common drain amplifier, which is something like that. So this one is V out, this one is V in. So already you know that this V out potential is nothing but the potential drop between the drain to source. And obviously our emphasis will be to make this particular MOS M1 in the saturation region. So in order to make it in the saturation region, the condition is that the drain to source voltage must be greater than the gate to source voltage minus the threshold voltage. So V out, it should be greater than or equal to V in minus VTH. Rather, I can also write V out should be greater than or equal to VGS1 minus VTH. So if I just follow that particular condition, that V out should be greater than equal to VGS1 minus VTH. So that is the minimum possible value for V out. So if the value of V out is less than VGS1 minus VTH, then obviously the M1, this MOS, will be driven into the triode region or linear region, and that is not our purpose. So we have to always maintain this MOS in the saturation region. So therefore, this is the minimum possible value for V out, that is equal to VGS1 minus VTH, and the maximum possible value, as you can understand, is VDD. So automatically, the fluctuation or the swing for the output voltage, which we always want to maximize, that swing is from VGS1 minus VTH to VDD. So that is for the simple common source type amplifier, which we have discussed in the last day. Now let us consider a different scenario. Whenever this particular common drain type amplifier is connected in cascade with another common source is connected in cascade with a common drain amplifier, then what is the penalty, or rather what is the cost that we are paying here? So we have to identify that part as well. So let me just consider a circuit like this. So let us consider the first circuit is kept as it is. So this circuit is kept as it is, that is VDD. We have this MOS M1. This one is V in. Now suppose this point is connected, this output terminal is connected to the input of a common drain amplifier or source follower circuit. So for the source follower, it should be connected to the gate, and the drain is connected to VDD directly. Let me just erase that part. Yeah. So suppose this is the second MOS M2, and suppose here the source resistance is being represented by means of another MOS amplifier, which is having a constant gate potential. Let it be VB, and the final output that we're talking about over here. Is taken from this particular terminal. And suppose this potential, say, let it be say VA. Suppose this MOS is known as the M3, MOS number 3. So here we have three different MOSes. So we can also represent that current source by means of another MOS, but this will not be included into our analysis or into our calculation. So that's why we have left it as it is by means of a simple current source. So here we have seen that the minimum value of the V out is like VGS1 minus VTH. This gate to source voltage of the first of this MOS amplifier minus the threshold voltage, that is VTH. Now, what about this particular thing? So here we do have, first of all, you have to identify the two different, this one is the common source, CS, and this one is the common drain. So common source, common drain cascade amplifier. And accordingly, you have to identify what about the corresponding swing of the output voltage, whether the swing has been changed or not. So that we have to identify. So here, as you know, this V out, this V out for this particular case, it should be automatically greater than VGS3 minus VTH3. It should be greater than that in order to make M3 into saturation, because we have already mentioned that the purpose of M3 is to act like a current source. Now, if I want to make it as a current source, so it must work in the saturation region. So under this condition, this drain to source voltage must be greater than the gate to source voltage minus the threshold voltage. So V out should be greater than VGS3 minus VTH3. Gate to source voltage of the third MOS minus the threshold voltage of the third MOS. So VGS3 minus VTH, that is nothing but the V out. So the minimum value of V out here is equal to VGS3 minus VTH3. Now, what about this potential VA? So this potential VA, as you understand, so VA is nothing but the gate potential of the second MOS, or you can also say this is nothing but the drain potential of the first MOS. So this is nothing but VD1, the drain potential of the first MOS, or you can equivalently say like, this is nothing but the gate potential of the second MOS, right? Like VG2. So what is VG2? Or what is VG? So this is nothing but you can write like VGS plus VS, as simple as that. The gate potential is nothing but gate to source drop plus the source. So therefore, already you have identified the source potential of this MOS. So this VG2 can be represented like VGS2 plus VS2. VGS2 plus VS2. What about VS2? So VS2 is nothing but V out. VS2 is nothing but V out. So VGS2 plus V out. So VA, since V out is greater than or equal to VGS3 minus VTH3 in order to make M3 into saturation. So therefore, VA should be greater than or equal to, if I just put the value of V out over here, so you have VGS2 plus VGS3 minus VGS3. Now, if I assume that for each of the MOS, they are having almost equal overdrive voltage. So then what we find for the first amplifier, whenever we have only a single common source kind of amplifier, CS, common source kind of amplifier, we have the variation of the output voltage is from VGS1 minus VTH to VDD. So the minimum possible value or minimum allowable value for the output voltage over here is equal to VGS1 minus VTH. Now, whenever you have connected the output voltage of this common source stage to another common drain stage, which will act as a simple buffer. So obviously you understand that this particular amplifier stage doesn't have any impact on amplifying the signal amplitude. Rather, it will act as a buffer. It will be used to connect the higher load resistance to a lower one. So that is the sole purpose of using a common drain amplifier or source follower amplifier. But while doing that, the additional penalty, what you need to pay over here is that the corresponding variation of VA is now, so as you can understand here, so let me once again explain how to reach at this particular point. So as you know, this lower MOS, the MOS number 3 or M3, will be acting as a current source. So therefore, it is our objective to make it or keep it in the saturation region. So the drain to source voltage should be greater than equal to the gate to source voltage minus the threshold voltage. Therefore, Vout is greater than equal to VGS3 minus VTH3. That is the one thing. And this potential VA is nothing but the drain potential of the first amplifier or M1, which is equal to the gate potential of the second amplifier, that is VG2. So that can be represented like VGS2 plus VS2. And if I just put the value of V out over here, which is nothing but VS2, we find that VA is now greater than or equal to VGS2 plus VGS3 minus VTH3. So therefore, here, as you can understand clearly, here the V out for the first case, it is greater than or equal to VGS1 minus VTH. While for the second case, it is greater than or equal to VGS2 plus VGS3 minus VTH. So therefore, if I just consider the available voltage swing, so the available voltage swing has been reduced. So the maximum possible value is VDD, that is fine. But the minimum value in the first case was VGS1 minus VT. So now if I assume that all of the MOS amplifiers, they are having almost the similar kind of gate to source overdrive. So therefore, if I just consider that VGS1 minus VTH and VGS3 minus VTH, they are VTH3, they are almost same. In fact, it will be like VTH1. So if I just assume that VGS1 minus VTH1 and VGS3 minus VTH3, they are the same. So in fact, the voltage swing for the second case, whenever we have used this common source, common drain cascade, then the voltage swing is reduced by an amount of VGS2. So the available swing that is possible in the second case is reduced by an amount of VGS2. So that is one of the disadvantages as far as the property or as far as the different attributes of the amplifiers are concerned. You know, gain is one of the attribute, that is the important attribute of an amplifier. Then we have the concept of bandwidth. We have the notion of input impedance. We have the notion of output impedance. Obviously, the power consumption is an important parameter. And apart from that, the voltage swing. So voltage swing is playing a pivotal role in some of the cases whenever the supply voltage is limited. So as the day are progressing, so the available voltage, available supply voltage is also reducing, because you know, we are now trying to develop the MOS devices for which the channel length is reducing day by day. So initially, we do have the channel length in the order of few microns. And now we are working in the area, some of the people who are working in the area of VLSI, now they are having the MOS devices with channel length as small as few nanometers. So from few micrometers to few nanometers, so almost a reduction by 1,000. So 10 to the minus 6 to 10 to the minus 9. So reduction by an amount of 1,000. So as the channel length is reduced, so as a matter of fact, the corresponding supply voltage is also reduced day by day.
So whenever the supply voltage is limited, then this fluctuation or then this voltage swing is also playing a very important role. So we have to find out some means so that this corresponding fluctuation or the voltage swing is kept at a high value. So this is the one of the disadvantage associated with the common drain amplifier or the source follower amplifier, that the corresponding fluctuation of the voltage swing is limited to some extent. So for this particular case, for a two-stage amplification, we have already seen that it has been dropped by a factor of, by an amount of VGS2 or another gate to source voltage. So this is the one of the drawbacks of this common drain. However, it is having several advantages as well. It will be acting as a buffer, a voltage buffer. Whenever you have to connect some very high value of load resistance or very low value of load resistance, then this common drain amplifier is the most popularly employed. So with this, I think I may conclude today's discussion on the common drain amplifier. And in the next day, I'll be talking about the last configuration which is left, that is known as a common gate kind of common gate configuration, which is almost equal to like your common base. So if I just compare this common source with the common emitter, common drain with the common collector, then the common gate kind of configuration is equivalent to what we have discussed in the circuits, electronic circuits, a common base amplifier. So anyway, so with this, let me conclude today's discussion on common drain amplifier.